Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Art Whisperer 88. Now, this is a brand new 12-inch by 14-inch gel plate. And I got this from Amazon. And I wanted to add this to my collection of different sizes. So I consider this a medium format. And let me just open the clamshell and show you the contents. Okay, so it comes in this very sturdy clamshell plastic container. And then here is the instruction manual in different languages. You have here the basics, how to clean, how to make marks, and some essential information. And here's a interesting but important piece of information right here. The gel plate contains mineral oil. Do not leave the plate sitting on an absorbent surface like a wooden table. So I have dealt with this situation before by using a acetate sheet or plastic sheet if you want to put your gel plate away. And I always make sure that I put it back in its proper container. So anyway, here is brand new gel plate, and it comes with two sheets of acetate, which I always keep. Just put this away. So I am going to show you how to center your image on your paper. Now, my paper is a 15-inch by 22-inch watercolor paper. And I always like to make sure that the image is smack in the middle. So I will show you how to register that. So no matter how many layers you do, it will always land in the same place. I'm going to show that to you. Okay, now the first step is to set up the printing paper. Now this is an inexpensive watercolor paper from Blick. It's called Blick watercolor paper, and it is a medium weight, so it's not very heavy. But it's sturdy enough to stand up to the plate. So it measures 15 this way, and it measures 22 this way. So it's 15 by 22. So I took half of 15, which is 7.5. So I mark 7.5 and 7.5 here. That will be my center line. Now this will be the most important line. This runs from top to bottom. And then The center line of 22 is 11. So that's right here. So this is the center point. Just eyeballing it. So the border will be approximately an inch and a half on both sides. Okay, so I have traced the shape of the gel plate according to the measurements. Oh, this is an inch and a half, an inch and a half. This is 4 inches and this is 4 inches. So it's centered on the paper. Now I cut out that dimension. So the gel plate is placed properly now. Now here is my old registration bar, and I want to show this to you because this is something that anyone can do. You don't need a fancy or elaborate setup to do a registration bar. Now you can get this from any hardware or any big box store like Home Depot or Lowe's. This is an L-shaped molding. This is used to cover corners. Now I like it because it has a lip, and this will catch the paper. I'll show you in a moment. So I made a little tick mark here to mark the middle of the paper. Yeah, let me move this. So I'm going to use the tick mark, line it up with the center line of the paper, and the same way with this mark here will be lined up with the center of this side. Okay. So I'm going to take some mounting tape. You can use double stick tape, but that's not that strong. I like to use something a little stronger. So I'm going to use mounting tape. Or you can use hot glue and make sure that these two bars don't move. So every time you lay your paper on the gel plate, it's going to land in the same place. I'll show that to you in a moment. Okay, now here we are at the next step. Here's some mounting tape. So I don't need a whole lot. It's just small pieces. Thank you. Okay, I find that these are more effective. I tried the mounting tape and it happened to be old, so it didn't work. So these are pretty nifty and they hold tight to the table until the next printing session. So anyway, I got that set down. So now I'm all set to print. And when I put the paper down, it will always fall in the center. Okay, so on to the next step. Okay, everybody, here's the next step. I went ahead and did some very simple collages using my template as a shield or a bib. What the template does, it tells me where the gel plate image is going to fall. So I did three. No, this is just black tissue paper and copy paper. What's the second one? Here's the third one. This is still a little wet. Okay. So what I intend to do is print over these to create some kind of composition. So I will be using, instead of using my usual Blicrylic raw sienna, I will be using studio acrylic yellow oxide. This is kind of exciting because I'm breaking in the plate. I've never used it before. It's very similar to yellow ox, raw sienna. It's almost the same. Okay, now I'm going to make some marks with a Q-tip. few scribbles. Okay. So here is the first collage. Okay, let's see what we have here. Pretty cool. The layer of paint kind of tones down the harshness of the black. And it actually picked up everything. There's not hardly any paint left. That's because the plate is brand new. Okay, let me try again for the second collage. This time I'm going to cut some strips. It's a little different effect. This time I will try some reusable stencils. Now, this is what I meant by having your image fall in the same place each time. This allows me to do a series of prints and they are consistent. You have the image falling in the same place. It doesn't shift all over the place. And I can do layers and keep adding. And it will always be registered. So the first step, which is kind of tedious and labor intensive, it pays off. You will find if you do that, you will realize how important it is. Different effect. Going to use contrasting color. Thank you. Okay, let's see what we have. Very cool. See, what I notice when the plate is brand new, it releases the paint very readily. And since my plates are quite old, they're almost 2 years old, I have to keep maintaining it with baby oil, which is okay. It just shows you should know how to maintain your plates to keep them in good shape. So I will air dry this and see if I can keep going. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to take a brief pause and air dry these pieces and then come back, decide what else I can do. So don't go away. Okay, we are getting down to the wire here. These are dry. This is the first print. Now I am going to introduce some of my warm-up exercises. That there. And then here are some papers that I offload my brayer. So I'm going to make use of the bright orange as an accent. Okay, that's for the first print. I'll just set this aside to dry. That's number two. Here's number three. Collage number three, and here is the final one, which is a ghost print. Thank you. Okay, again, I will say 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces, 4 collages from this session. I'm going to air dry them and then maybe place a final step. So I'll be right back. Okay, everybody, so this has dried by now. Now I want to feature a wonderful birthday present from a favorite viewer of mine. Thank you, Carol. This was so sweet of you to give me a set of Posca pens. And these are pastel colors. And I think as a final touch, it might be cool to add some marks with these pens. So I have here like a peach color and one is a pink. So let's see. Let me just make sure this writes. Yep, works beautifully. So let's see. I just want to add some a little touch of color. Just a little accent color, I think. It gives a little touch of whimsy. There. So that is the first collage. print number 2. Okay, and this is the ghost print. Okay, I think that completes it. Here's a close-up. And finally, here's the ghost print. Okay, I hope you like this video. Please give it a like, a thumbs up. And once again, thank you, Carol, for your wonderful gift. It will not go to waste, that's for sure. I will find good use for it. Thank you so much for subscribing and watching. And by the way, these prints will be available for purchase on my website, artwhisperer88.com. And for those who can, could you give some support to my PayPal to help keep this channel going? So thank you again once more, and I hope to see you next time.